This is Supreme Headquarters, Allied Expeditionary Force, General Dwight D. Eisenhower.
People of Western Europe, a landing was made this morning on the coast of France by troops of the Allied Expeditionary Force. This landing is part of a concerted United Nations plan for the liberation of Europe, made in conjunction with our great Russian allies.
The liberation, like the message that signaled it, came in many tongues. The French of Charles de Gaulle.
La bataille suprême est engagée. Après tant de combats, de fureur, de douleur, voici venu le choc décisif.
And a Polish foreign minister in exile.
Żołnierze, lotnicy, marynarze Polacy. Wkraczamy w decydującą fazę generalnej rozgrywki I porachunku z Niemcami.
Those who were there say King Haakon wept as he spoke to Norway.
Landsmen, some did it in store strategic plan. Some had tal sikte på frigøring av Europas undertrykte folk.
There were messages from the Dutch, the Danes, the Luxembourgers, and the Belgians.
Mes chers compatriotes, les opérations préliminaires pour la libération de l'Europe ont commencé.
I call upon all who love freedom to stand with us now. Together we shall achieve victory.
Some of the broadcasts of those first 24 hours achieved a special kind of permanence. One of these originated on the headquarters ship Ancon, just off the French coast. Your reporter, George Hicks of the ABC.
Our own ship has just gave its warning whistle, and now flak is coming up in the sky. Looks like we're going to have a night tonight.
Get him there, Lonnie! Another one coming over. And a cruiser right alongside of us is pouring it up.
Something burning is falling down through the sky. And it's circling down. Maybe a hit plane. Got one.
The history of wars does not know of any undertaking so broad in concept and so grandiose in its scale and masterful in its execution.